Do you know what a VoIP or voice over IP is? Do you know the protocols that VoIP uses, such as SIP or session initiation protocol? What about RTP or real-time transport protocol? Do you know your codecs, such as G711 or G729 or G722? In this example, I've got some phones registered to a free 3CX PBX or private branch exchange or private telephone system. PBXs have been around for many, many years. I'm so old that I remember working with VoIP solutions 20 years ago. What I love about the 3CX solution is that you can set up your own telephone system or PBX or private branch exchange using just apps on a phone. So as an example here, I've got the 3CX app running on an Android phone, and I can simply call a user as follows and then answer the call. I'll mute it so that we don't get feedback, but notice as simple as that to set up a call between a soft phone and a physical phone. I could call this user as an example and answer the call. Or from a hard phone, call is ringing on a physical phone as well as a soft phone. Now, what's great is you don't have to buy physical phones like I've done here. You can simply install a 3CX app on an Android phone or an iOS phone and then learn about voice over IP protocols. In this example, I've got Skype running on this phone. I'm going to call my US telephone number, which is +1 917 259, etc. So I'm going to call that number, and notice what's going to happen. That call is going to be routed to the United States, and it's going to ring on these two phones. So as an example, I'll answer the call on the physical handset. Now I'll mute the line because otherwise we're going to get a lot of feedback here. Now please note, I am calling from a UK phone. Call is made internationally to a United States telephone number. You can see on this phone that the number displayed is 44203 and some other numbers. That's possible because I'm paying $1 a month for this telephone number. Now, I've actually set up a ring group here, so hence it shows ring group, because I don't just want the calls to go to a single phone. I might want it to hunt between different phones. So let's make this call again. So I'll ring the number once again, US telephone number. But in this case, I'll answer it on this phone. Now, what I could do on this phone as an example is transfer the call. And what you'll hear here, hopefully, is music is playing. I'm going to do a blind transfer. And I'll answer it here. And notice the call has been transferred. So I have now made a call to a US telephone number that was received on this phone. And I've simply transferred the call to this phone. Now, that's a very simple example of a telephone system, in this case, using a hard phone or physical phone and three soft phones or applications, as we'd call it today. This is a simple 3CX application running on my phone. As mentioned, the 3CX SMB solution is free if you have 10 or fewer users. That's hosted in the cloud. But for deployments in the real world, they have a professional solution as well as an enterprise solution. Professional solution is £265 a year if you have 25 users, and you could scale that. So the price would go up depending on the number of users you have. This is a dedicated server that you can run on premise, and therefore you can self-host it. Now, I think the SMB solution is fantastic if you want to learn about protocols, if you want to learn about VoIP, SIP, RTP, codecs, et cetera, et cetera. But in the real world, a lot of companies use 3CX, and they mention how 355,000 companies, including Toyota, Coca-Cola, BMW, et cetera, use 3CX. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to set up the SMB solution. It's very easy to get this up and running. In subsequent videos, if you're interested, let me know. I'll show you how to set up a professional version and host that locally. You could host this in the cloud. You could host it on Amazon or Azure as an example, or directly with 3CX, or you could run it within a virtual machine, even run it on Windows. So I'll show you some of those options. Let me know if you're interested in learning about port forwarding. You have to learn about port forwarding firewalls. So as an example, how to set this up so that pfSense allows protocols through so that this can communicate with phones on the internet, or trunks as an example. You need to learn about trunks. So how to set up a VoIP trunk so that you can actually make and receive phone calls. Now, before we continue, I want to thank 3CX for sponsoring this video and supporting my channel and hopefully allowing me to create more technical content that helps you. Let me know in the comments if you like this type of content and if you enjoy seeing something very different. I think it's fantastic that you can build your own private telephone system emphasis on private that you can control. But I think it's fantastic that you can host this yourself, and it's a private solution that doesn't cost a huge amount of money like these kinds of systems used to in the past. So what I'll do now is show you how to set this up from the very beginning. We'll use a free cloud-based solution in this video once again, and in a second video, I'll show you how to set this up on-prem or locally. So what I'll do here is create an account. Notice you have various options. You can try 3CX Pro for free, no credit card required, no strings attached, so that's fantastic. Or you can just go for a small solution. So what I'll do is sign up with my email, put in my name, put in my email address, and click Let's Go. So as you can see, account is already created. So what we're told now is that we need to verify our email and put in the code. So I'll put in my code here and click Submit. I have to put in some information like my first name and my last name, how many users will be in my system. So I'll just say 1 to 10 at the moment. And then I need to put in my password. You need to agree to the license agreement. So read that and then click Next. Okay, so now you have various options. Are you going to do self-hosted in a private cloud where you can take full control and host on Amazon, Google, Azure, or DigitalOcean? Are you going to do on-premise, so in your office? Are you going to do 3CX hosted, or are you going to do a SMB solution that's hosted by 3CX? So I'll just do that for the moment. Very basic setup, but that allows you to create 3CX for free. Only cost, once again, is to receive calls or to make outbound calls. Okay, so the 3CX system is created, and notice we're told where we can log in, username and our password. So I'll copy the password, and so what I'll do is click login. So I'll log in with my username and my password and click login. And notice straight away we're told that we can install the 3CX app on a phone. So this phone was previously registered to a different phone system. So what I'll do here is simply delete the app. So I'll select the app and delete it. So uninstall it, search for it again in the Play Store, uninstall it. I'll click open. And again, all I need to do now is agree to the license and then scan the QR code and literally just do that. And notice it says, hello, David Bumble. Press continue. And as you can see there, the phone is now registered. So as simple as that to get a phone set up on my system. So if I go to admin users, and let's change this to dark mode. So dark mode is going to be easier to read. So again, going to admin users, notice I've already got a user set up. Now for the SMB solution, you can't set your telephone extension numbers. So as an example here, my telephone number is 14610, but on the other solutions, you can set up a telephone number range. So as an example, you could just use a 4-digit numbering system. So 1000 to 1999 as an example. Or you might just decide to have 100 to 199. It's really up to you. So what I'll do here is add another user. So notice the extension number was automatically set for me. So what I'll do here is say user two, should really choose better names than that. But as simple as that to set up another user. So what I'll do is click on QR code to set up another user. So on this phone, once again, I need to remove the app. I'll search for 3CX and install that. So again, all I've done is install the app on the phone. I'll press open, agree to the license agreement, and now I've got to scan the QR code. So as simple as that, I've got user two set up now, give it permission, and notice on my team, I've got two users now. So if I press user two, call is made to the second phone, and I've got a call between these two phones. It's as simple as that to set up a telephone system. Now, I mean, that's okay, but you probably want to make outbound calls. So what we need to do is go to voice and chat and add a trunk. So in my example, I'll just say all outbound calls. You could use a better name than that. I'm going to use a US provider. In this case, it's call centric. I need to put the main trunk number. So I'm going to view modify extensions. Here's my main trunk number. I need to specify the authentication ID and password. So my username is going to be that, my password. So I'll put in the new password. I'll click apply. And then we're told to reboot our device. And here I'll click save. At the moment, it's showing red. One of the things we need to do is whitelist the IP address of the 3CX system. At the moment, the only whitelisted device is the previous 3CX system that I configured. So what I'm going to do is change the IP address. So I've whitelisted that, so calls can only be made from my new phone system. Okay, so there you go. All outbound calls trunk is now gone green. So on my call-centric system, notice phone is registered. So that means I should be able to make a call to one of these new phones. But before I do that, I need to tell it where it's going to go. So at the moment, it's only going to go to this phone, but I could set up a ring group. But let's just test making a call to that number. So I'm on 5G on this phone. I'm making a call from the UK to a US telephone number, and hopefully that should ring on this phone. And there you go. As you can see, call has been answered there. It was actually also ringing on my laptop, but there you go. I've been able to make a call from the UK to the US. I got a phone registered with a brand new phone system. I got this to receive calls, and then hopefully it'll also be able to make outbound calls. So let's test that. So I'll kill this call. So let's try that 914-202.
3CX cannot reach the number you called.
Okay, so I need to make sure that for my outbound rules, I actually allow calls. So I'm going to say all outbound calls. I'm not going to set a prefix, but the trunk I'm going to select is all outbound calls. So, I mean, you probably want to use a better name than that, like call centric or whatever your system is. So let's try again. So US number 914-202.
The number you have dialed is invalid or not in service. Okay. Please check the number and dial again.
So I'm getting a US accent there. So I'm definitely making a call to the US. So let's try it with 001 in this case. And there you go. That's ringing on this phone. And I could answer that. Testing.
Testing.
And there you go. I've got a call from a US phone system to a US telephone number that's now ringing on this phone. That works because I've got Skype with both a US as well as a UK number here. So I could end the call over here. And the call now ends. Now, I haven't set this up very well. You probably want to do stuff here like call this number, start with a prefix. So you could strip digits or you could do stuff to the call to make it better. So as an example, you could prepend 001 here so that you don't have to put in the international dialing code. So I'll just ring 914-202. I noticed that works again because I prepended the correct digits to the phone number. So when you set up PBXs as an example, or phone systems like this, you will decide what to do with calls like stripping digits, adding digits, etc. So in my example, I prepended 001 to make sure that it's a US number, but obviously it wouldn't make sense to do that for all outbound calls. You might only want to do that for certain calls, as an example, only to US telephone numbers. Now in this example, the physical phone is still connected to the previous system. To change this, you could just change the username and password and the server that we're communicating to, and then that would be able to register to the new phone system. But I think that's enough for this first introductory video. What do you think? Did you enjoy this video? What kind of stuff do you want me to show you? Fantastic that 3CX has a solution, I think, that allows you to set up a PBX or private phone system for free, but also for businesses. And I mean, that's where this is geared. It's not really for individuals. This is more a business solution. You can pay for the professional or enterprise solution, and you can decide whether you want to host that yourself or host it with them. The advantage of hosting it yourself is you control it. You have full control of the system. You just pay a yearly fee rather than a per line or per device fee. So much cheaper than other systems out there. Very easy to set up, very easy to use. Again, let me know in the comments the kind of stuff that you want to see, what you want me to create content about with regards to 3CX. I think it's going to be fantastic to look at the signaling, look at how to set this up locally so that you can have your own private phone system that's not reliant on a cloud solution. But let me know in the comments. I'm David Bomble. I want to wish you all the very best.